Hello there, I'm Blackbright, broadcasting out of the UK. Welcome to my channel. For those who are passing by for the first time, please subscribe, share and like. For my existing subscribers, thank you very much for your support. I actually got an email today, and that's why I'm going to respond on the next subject. It was about a neighbour who is concerned about how old is she? 79-year-old Veronica Gordon. Apparently, she lives in a shared ownership home. Shared ownership home, for those of you who don't know, is where you part buy and you part rent. The part that you buy, you can either take it out on a mortgage or you can pay it outright and you just pay rent on the balance. And it's supposed to be for people with either low income, and it's what the council did a long time ago when they did the right to buy. So for people who couldn't buy outright, they could buy a portion of it. And then eventually, if you want to buy more shares, you can staircase, which means you can keep buying shares into it so your mortgage is more but your rent is less. The only thing with that, though, is that when you staircase, the price of the house, if it goes up, your percentage goes up as well. So if you bought the house for like 50,000, your 50% share was 50,000, say about 10 years ago, and you paid say 100,000 for the place, so your stake would be 50,000 and the rental value of the property would be on the other side, the council or the housing, usually housing associations, and the housing association is the landlord. So you don't pay any buildings insurance, you just pay rent and service charge, because the balance of it is a leasehold. The reason I'm going into this is very relevant, because Veronica Gordon, she bought this, she bought her, I don't know if, what her percentage share was, but she did part buy her home. And when she bought it, she was very vulnerable. Apparently she lives near an alley, and she felt, as she was getting older, she wanted to put a gate up to feel safe. Anyway, she got planning permission. This is 30 years ago. She got planning permission, put the gate up, and that was fine. Anyway, more recently, the housing association, as you know, people buy and sell and businesses transfer over. So the housing association that she originally got the house from and who gave her planning permission for the gate, sold or transferred their interest to a company called Eastend Homes. Now, Eastend Homes decided that the gate was a fire hazard. If anything happened, Veronica Gordon would be locked out, locked in, and it's not easy access for the fire engines, so they wanted her to take it down. Veronica Gordon is adamant that she's not taking it about. She says she feels vulnerable, and she's scared if she takes the gate down, and that apparently they've taken it down and she's putting it back up, and they've taken it down and she's put it back up. And I think this happened about three times. Anyway, it's got to the point now where she's gone to court, and they're saying that if she doesn't take the gate down by the 2nd of next month, which is a couple of weeks ago, 2nd of September, she's going to do jail time. At 79 years old. Now, this little strong Jamaican lady who came in on the Windrush in the 1950s is adamant that she is not taking that gate down. She says they're using bully tactics on her and she will go to prison. And I'll tell you something, my mum, as she gets older, she gets more and more stubborn. What happens as you get older is that you feel as though people think you're stupid. You feel as though people are going to take advantage of you. You feel as though people don't think that you know your rights. And so you kick your heels in and you decide they are not going to take advantage of me. There's two things here. Like I said, When you part own a property, part of it is yours, the other part is the housing association or whoever the other part belongs to. And they still have rights, and you cannot make any structural changes or any major changes without their permission. Now, she got permission from the previous landlords. So what is her position now? That is the question. It appears that she now has to abide by the new landlord's regulations. And she feels as though it's unfair. She feels as though they're coming over as heavy-handed. She feels bullied and all sorts. I'm not quite sure what the answer is, but they wanted me to draw it to your attention just for comments, basically. Just so if anybody can, you know, give her some advice. Personally, 79-year-old, I wouldn't want to go to jail. But you know me, I'm squeamish, me freely, freely, and all them kind of things. So I don't like no kind of rough treatment. I don't want to be stuck behind bars. I don't want to hear that gate clanging. I don't want to be sitting on a toilet and the door is ajar. I don't want to be molested by other females or abused or hit up and stuff. I'm not going to say that they might do all of that as a 79-year-old, but you never know. And as much as she's feisty and as much as she's strong and as much as she looks strong, you know, prison isn't the place for an elderly lady. It's not the place. So personally, I would say take the gate down, ask them to give you, I understand that they're going to put a secure door. But I can understand what she means, because if it's by an alleyway, she's had kids running up and down and making noise and loitering down the alleyway. So the gate, I'm not quite sure how the gate is positioned, is to stop these kids running up and down the alleyway. And with all what's going on now, I can understand her concerns. But at the same time, she needs to be sensible and think about what other precautions can she take rather than be sent to prison. I don't know for how long. I think they want to send her there for 6 months. Anyway, I'm going to put the link below and I'm going to read what I have now, as it came from the source. So that was just my opinion, my little two pence worth. Windrush great grandmother faces spending her 80th birthday behind bars in a row with the housing association over a security grill she installed to make her feel safe. Veronica Gordon, 79, has had the gate at the front of her flat for 30 years. She had council planning permission for when it was installed. But Eastend Homes say that the metal grill represents a fire hazard. She has been engaged in a decade-long dispute with the Housing Association. She has been handed a six-month suspended sentence for contempt of court. Apparently, she's been to court twice. She was supposed to go another two times and she didn't turn up. It doesn't say what the reason was. So that is why she's been handed a six-month sentence. I mean, you know, boy, you've got to give it to them, though, you know what I mean? When they don't bow, when they don't back down, you've got to give it to them. But boy, I think you've got to be sensible too, honestly. A Windrush, okay. Veronica Gordon claims she has been ruthlessly targeted by the Housing Association for a decade, despite having council planning permission for the metal grill. So I think it's a question of whether or not the new landlords can supersede the instructions of the previous landlords. That's what I would have to find out. And whether or not it truly does constitute a fire hazard. If it constitutes a fire hazard, then it would have to come down. Remember Grenfell Tower when they couldn't get out? Is she able, if that house caught fire, is she able to get out freely without any restriction? Is the fire service able to access the building without any restrictions? How is the gate? Is it locked? Would she have to go upstairs and get the key? Where is the key held? You know, there's a lot of things, and it's one of those big wire iron gates. So I don't know whether... The great-grandmother first installed the gate at her East London flat with council planning permission in 1989. But last Friday, a judge handed Veronica, 79, a six-month suspended prison sentence for failing to take it down. He ordered her to remove it by last Wednesday or face jail, but she refused, claiming she does not feel safe without it. It is the latest event in a decade-long saga between Veronica and social housing Eastend Homes, who say the gate that cordons off a dead-end alley that leads only to her flat is a fire risk. So only leads to her flat. And it's a fire risk, and it's a dead-end alley. Veronica, who moved to the UK from Jamaica in the 1950s, said, "I feel harassed and stressed. The great-grandmother first installed the gate at her East London." Oh, that's all. There's repeated that. "I can't understand grown people behaving the way they are. It's bully tactics, and I won't be bullied." This is what Veronica's saying. "All I want now is to enjoy my retirement in peace." The pensioner was first arrested in 2009, her first brush with the law, when estate managers called officers to her flat in Mile End in East London. The ordeal concerned local MP Jim Fitzpatrick and outraged then MP George Galloway, who branded the housing association as unaccountable. I don't know what that means, unaccountable. He said it was a civil case and called the pensioner's treatment as mob-handed. Veronica, who part-bought her house for $12,900 in 1977 under the right-to-buy scheme, insists the gate does not pose a risk to neighbours because it only blocks access to her property. Like I said, if it only blocks access to her property, God forbid there was a fire, would she be able to get out? That is the question. If she cannot get out without fumbling around looking for keys, then it would be a fire hazard. Despite facing jail time, the stubborn septuagenarian, which is another word for 70, I don't know why they have all these years. Why can't they just say this stubborn 70-year-old? Is not budging because the gate makes her feel safe in her own home and she does not want to let those bully boys win. So now this is rebelliousness now. Before the latest court case last Friday, Veronica, because this only came out today, I think it was the 20th. Yeah, I think this is fresh off the press. Before the latest court case last Friday, Veronica provided the judge with GP's letter listing the medical reasons why she could not attend, but it was dismissed. So apparently she had a letter to say why she couldn't attend court, but they dismissed it and they still given a six-month sentence for contempt of court, which isn't fair. Veronica, who moved to the UK... Judge Saggerson at the County Court of Central London said this is regrettably a case of non-attendance in court. The judge handed Veronica a six-month suspended prison sentence for contempt of court. She now has until September the 2nd to explain herself in court and to take the gate down. Faced with the prospect of spending her 80th birthday in jail, Veronica said, "I'm not scared of going to prison. If I come up against a judge, I will ask him three questions. One, what crime have I committed? Two, why is it a crime to have a gate? And three, why are you gunning for me to go to prison?" Oh, these little old ladies, honestly, they're something else. Eastend Homes also pursued Veronica's daughter, Janice Gordon, 52, who was on the property deeds until her mother bought the leasehold outright in 2017. They might be careful. They better be careful, you know, because next thing you'll say, they'll be saying that she's mad, put her in a home and take away the house. So she better be careful. These people, they can be devious. Anyway, Veronica said the association even sent a retired Jamaican employee to her home because she would be better able to communicate with her. Eastend Homes have said they are saddened by the situation and definitely do not want Veronica jailed. Veronica said, if they are sad, then why don't they stop? I've spoken to their solicitors from Bachelor's Law Firm and pushed judges to jail me. The lawyer is only going by the instructions of Eastend Homes, and now they say they're sad. Of course they would, the bullies. On top of that, they are taxpayers funded and paying legal fees of £155 per hour. People might ask why I don't just take the gate down and avoid all of this. I won't let these bully boys win, and I need the gate to feel safe. I can understand her saying she needs the gate to feel safe, but when she's saying she doesn't want these bully boys to win, it's like it's becoming a competition. I mean, it's becoming a point where maybe she's not being rational. Because sometimes when you are in that state of mind where you feel as though somebody's going to have something over you, and so you're not going to relent, so you're going to stick your heels in, you're not going to bow down, you're not going to back down, because you don't want them to win. And it's to your disadvantage. And with her, it's the same thing. She's saying, I don't want those bully boys to win, so she ain't backing down. But what is the repercussions? Is that sensible? Honestly, when you people make decisions, they have to be sensible and rational. And I can understand how she feels bullied. And I can understand that. But she has to think of herself and her welfare. Remember, prison isn't a nice place. You don't get no clean cups. You don't get to choose what you eat. You don't get to choose where you sit. Please, Veronica, think about it. Honestly, from my heart, think about it. You don't want to go to one of these prisons. You don't know what kind of guard you're going to get. You don't know if they're racist or whether what kind of people they are. Why would you subject yourself over a gate? A gate is material. And I know one thing with Jamaica, they have their pride too, you know. That's another thing. But pride comes before a fall. You know, my mother always said that. Pride comes before a fall. A fall. A fall. Not a fool. Yeah, a fool. So you have to be really, really think about when you're sticking your heels in and when you have this pride and, you're not going to back down and blah, blah, blah. It's stupidness. It really is stupidness, because who loses in the end? You end up in prison. If you're not out and you can't, well, you're leasehold, but if you don't pay your rent, well, I guess your daughters could pay it. But they could use anything to take back that house. And that's the thing, when these part by, what are they called again, shared ownership homes, you stop paying your rent, you lose everything. They can take the whole house back. Even though you've got a mortgage on it, they can take that house if you don't pay the rent. So there's lots of things to think about. Anyway, so Veronica now has until September the 2nd to explain herself in court and take the gate down. The council gave Veronica permission to fit the gate in 1989 after she claimed residents were causing nuisance along the corridor in front of her first floor flat. So she's actually in a flat. This is just something else. Can you imagine? What if she's in one of these flats and then she's put a gate up? Honestly. But then I don't understand the alleyway. It's a pity I couldn't see the picture, because then I could kind of get an image of what it, you know, the actual, take, put it into context of whether or not it's safe or whether it's not, whether or not the request is reasonable or it's not, whether or not what the East End Homes has any credence to what they're saying, or whether she's valid in her in being quite stern and sticking with her gate. I can't really say. I mean, if it doesn't block the fire engines from getting to her, there shouldn't be any real reason to take down the gate. But I don't know. I don't know what the building is like. Anyway, since the battle began, the estate has removed the gate 3 times, but Veronica has placed it repeatedly. So she have money to put back a gate, because they're not cheap, those gates. The mother of 4 has been summoned to court 6 times for her actions, attending 2. The spokesperson for the Housing Association said Eastend Homes is deeply saddened this case has ever reached court. Our priority is the safety of our residents. We need to remove the gate from the communal area leading up from her home because it represents a fire hazard and the rescue hazard to Veronica and her neighbouring residents. We are compassionate to Veronica's security concerns and have offered to replace her existing door with a new secure by design front door. I don't think her issue is her front door. I think her issue where she feels, whether or not she feels safe, is the actual alleyway, the walkway. That's where she doesn't feel safe, because you're having people walking up and down there all the time, all hours of the night. I guess they could go into the window. So I don't think her issue is the door. So they'd have to think of something else. I don't know what. Our staff has consistently tried to communicate with Veronica to resolve this situation, and we will continue to do so to ensure her home is safe and presents no fire risk to herself or others. And I'll put the link underneath. So yeah, so she'll have to look at the terms of the lease. Shared ownership, part by part rent criteria has changed over the years. It used to be for people over a certain age or young families starting out. And like in back in the day, if you had a council property, you could do it that way, right to buy. And I think some low income families who had a certain amount of income could get it. I don't think they're so easy to get now, but there's quite a few, but they're not so cost effective as they used to be, because in some cases, I was looking at some the other day, the rent is so high. So even though it's part mortgage and part rent, the rent is so high. So, and if you can't afford to pay off the whole mortgage and you've got mortgage to pay, plus that percent, plus the rent, that can work out to be a lot of money. So the leasehold part of it, which is the part that she's paying rent on, is normally 99 years. So she's probably got about 40 years left on it. The Household Association, or Eastend Homes in this case, is her landlord. So they do have a say in what happens with their property, with their 50%. They need to look at, so really they need to look at the terms of the lease. I don't know if the lease changed when Eastend Homes took it over. That's another question. Did the lease change? Did they, you know, when it was taken over by a new company or a new housing association, did they change the lease? If they didn't change the lease and she's still under the old lease, she should be able to abide by that lease and keep the gate. I know that in nearly all shared ownership properties, you're restricted with regard to structural alterations. You can paint it, of course, but nothing structural. What else? Previously approved, superseded by new landlord. Yeah. So that was all I've got to say now. So I hope I did that anonymous person who sent me the email, I hope I did it justice with this video. And I hope it answers some of your questions. Like I said, I try to weigh up, anytime I do present an argument, I do try to weigh up from both sides, so that to be fair more than anything else, and to be objective. And that's all for now. Bye-bye.